fake cake. Figata cake, as they say in Italian. No, they don't. It turned out great. Let's get into this. Everyone, welcome back to Quality Pops. My name is RuPaul. Let's make it a figata cake. So I'm starting with round pieces of styrofoam, and I cut them all into the same slice. We got multiple layers going on, and I really wanted something new for my background, so I decided to create a rainbow cake slice. I've got some paint that I bought at the Walmart, and I'm just gonna paint each slice a different color. It's Pride Month, you guys, and I'm as queer as a $3 coin, which is why we're making a rainbow cake. So once I finished painting all of my slices, I let them dry overnight, and then I started to stack. I'm using some silicone caulking as glue. It's going to be my fake icing. And I wanted to make sure that each of the layers of icing were the same thickness, so I'm using bubble tea straws or boba straws. So we're repeating the process over and over and over again until I have all of my rainbow cake layers stacked. And I'm gonna be adding some more fake icing on the outside of this cake, but I'm just, oh my God, this bird is like super loud right now. Have your conversation after the video, okay, please? Once I added my last cake layer, I let this set for another day just to make sure that everything was stable, and then I started to add the decoration. I wanted to make sure that none of my fake icing got on my cake layers because caulking, you guys, it's just not forgiving. So I covered each of my layers with some tape, and then I started to fill in the gaps in between each layer of fake cake with some more fake icing. I'm using some wooden craft sticks and just smoothing it out. And then I removed the tape, and it just looks so perfect, you guys. Oh God, it looks gorgeous. I love the way this turned out. I added more tape to the back of this so that it would protect the cake from the caulking when I'm adding the back layer of icing. Just like a real cake, I took my offset spatula, moved it up and down, strained it, and flanned it out as much as I could. It's still very textured because it's caulking, you can't get it completely flat. Then I added some clay sprinkles that I made. I didn't do a good job with these sprinkles, which is why it's a good idea that I'm not showing you this up close. But from far away, they look like real Jimmy sprinkles, so that's not bad. After I added all the sprinkles, it was time to add some decorative icing to the top and the bottom. I used the largest piping tip that I had. We got more sprinkles going on. I've got a pile of fake icing and a giant fake cherry to finish this baby off. Voila! Oh gosh, it looks so cool. Now, I did have to repaint this because I didn't like some of the color choices I made early on, but it turned out so well. I'm gonna be so proud to display this in the back of my videos, you guys. Now, I've got a ton of ideas for more fake cakes, so if you wanna see more like this, let me know in the comments and make sure you hit that like button. I hope you guys enjoyed this, and I hope that if you're a cake decorator, you attempt to make this for your background because it's such a cute idea. I love you guys. I will see you very soon. Bye.